हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, जय हिंद एंड वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग। एज यू ऑल नो, वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग द रिविजन्स ऑफ दोज टॉपिक इन ऑल चैप्टर्स ऑफ फर्स्ट टर्मिनल। इन दैट वॉट एवर चैप्टर वी आर सिलेक्टिंग फॉर रिविजन, इन दैट पर्टिक्युलर चैप्टर वी आर नॉट टारगेटिंग टू रिवाइज ऑल टॉपिक्स, बट दोज टॉपिक्स विच आई फील बाय द फीडबैक ऑफ द स्टूडेंट दैट दे फील लिटिल डिफिकल्ट, दोज टॉपिक्स विच any student feel little difficult, those topics we have been taking in revision. We in so far as you have already attended four revision lectures of rational number, I have already allocated the first three lectures only for the purpose of understanding problems of rational number which you may find little difficult. Then, as you all know, our planning is to deliver two lectures for understanding the representation of rational number on the number line. If you can remember, in lecture number 4, you have been explained how to represent proper fraction on number line. Before we move ahead for the next topic in lecture number 5 today, I just want to remind and revive those important points which were the highlights of lecture number 4. Any rational number, this needs to be kept in your mind forever whenever you come across any example regarding representation of rational number on the number line. Please keep it in mind. What we have learned? Any rational number which is positive and proper fraction lies between 0 to 1. Second important point, any rational number which is negative and proper fraction lies in the range of 0 to minus 1. You understood this? Today, in today's revision lecture number 5, we are going to target not proper fraction, because that we have already taken in our previous lecture, lecture number 4. In lecture number 5, we are going to target only improper fraction. Nobody is going to specify in exam either the given rational number is proper or improper. That is, you yourself have to determine whether it is proper or improper by the concept you are taught. Okay, so chapter number one, dear student. Name of the chapter, as you all know, rational numbers. Okay, rational numbers. And today, dear student, you are attending lecture number 5. Understand the revision lecture for the chapter rational number. Okay, we are going to target today presentation of improper fraction. Okay, let me start from, we have, dear student, we continue to maintain the sequence. We have in previous lecture number 4 did 6 example of representation on the number line. Okay, we continue the same sequence, number 7. Okay, and I am writing the sum here. Suppose, dear student, you have to represent this way. I write one number here, 11 upon, suppose we write 3, okay? First, what you need to target is, you have to decide, is it proper or improper fraction? Here, check, numerator is greater than denominator whenever, as you all know, numerator is greater than denominator, it is always called, it is always called improper fraction. Okay, dear student, it is always called improper fraction. So first thing, the rational number is in front of you, 11 upon 3, and as you know, it is improper fraction. Not only it is improper fraction, it is positive also. Understood? Now, two things has been decided. It is improper fraction. Not only that, it is positive. Now, it's a question of deciding the interval of two rational number between which this particular rational number lies. So, dear student, what you have to do, you have to convert this improper fraction into mixed fraction. You understood this? 11, let us convert it into mixed fraction. Okay, to be divided by 3, 3 3 9 to remainder. So mixed fraction you have already done, 3 integer 2 upon 3. Understand? Let me write it here, 11 upon 3. That is equal to 3 integer 2 upon 3. Okay? Number has been converted into mixed fraction. Okay? Now, dear student, please try to understand this number is converted into mixed fraction. How you speak this? 3 integer 2 upon 3. So this is you are speaking as integer. 3 is the integral value here. Which integer follows 3? 4. After 3, you are going to get the integer 4. So, dear student, it is decided that it lies between. It lies between. Please concentrate. First, you write this integer 3. And you write the next integer, which is that? 4. See, dear student, this is what you have to do first. Seeing the rational number, you decided that it is improper fraction because numerator is greater than denominator. It is positive. So, immediately you converted the improper fraction into mixed fraction. After converting into mixed fraction, you will get the two rational number 3 and next, that is 4. So this particular number lies in the range of 3 and 4. Okay, let us now draw number line. Okay, dear student, concentrate because I am going to give you same such example as in SLP, okay? So please concentrate. It has to lie between 3 and 4. So I do not want the rest of the number. If I just want to write, I can 1. 2, but my target is the extended portion between 3 and 4. This portion need to be extended because it is converted in mixed fraction and lies between 3 and 4. Now this section between 3 and 4 has to be divided into how many part? So look at this denominator. What is that? 3. So here you have to make 3 parts. And for that, only 2 marking you require, okay? 3 parts, okay? Is it clear? Now, as you know, this becomes 1 upon 3, this becomes 2 upon 3, this becomes 3 upon 3, that you all know. See, dear student, how I am writing for 1 upon 3. Two upon three. Here you do not have to write 3 upon 3 because that already comes for one. Okay. Now because you are numbering from integer, so you have to place this integer here. 3 integer 1 upon 3. 3 integer 2 upon 3. This way. Understood? Then you do not need to place any other at all. You understood this? So, dear student, portion between 3 and 4 divided into 3 parts. This is first part, 3 integer 1 upon 3. Then second part, 3 integer 2 upon 3. Okay, dear student. And then the 4, as you all know. Understood? You do not have to do anything at all with this. So this is the number you were targeting. Okay? 3 integer 2 upon 3. Please, first you need to verify this. Here, and you can, when you write 3 integer 2 upon 3, actually it was which number? 11 upon 3. This way you can mention. First, please verify it properly. One more example is in our revision lecture plan we do. I am going to give you one more example as a self-learning practice, okay, just now. That's why you just target this. Understand it properly. Mixed fraction, after converting into mixed fraction, you come to know that it lies in the range of 3 and 4, denominator 3 divided into 3 parts, 3 integer 1 upon 3. This integer you have to follow, 3 integer 2 upon 3. This way you can represent. Understand? Please verify this first. Then we will give you one more example for self-learning practice. Okay? Because in the improper fraction, you need to concentrate and you have to decide the interval. That's why we will back to back give you two improper fraction for SLP just now. Okay? First, this is clear. Please feel comfort. And be patient and understand with alertness before I give you two more example back to back for practice. Okay? Is it clear in your mind? So we move to example number 8. Okay? I am erasing it. One more example for SLP by you. Okay. One more example. Example number 8. As an SLP for you. Okay, let me give you the example. Just try this out. It is given 15, okay, upon 4. Please try this out. Take enough time. I'll give you 5 minutes for SLP. And you should be able to represent on the number line properly. Try this out. Just solve it. Take your time, understand the concept properly. See the number given to you, 15 upon 4, which is already a improper fraction. So first you need to convert it into a mixed fraction, and then it comes representation on the number line. Okay, so first you need to concentrate on this. Make it little fast so that we can also solve it on the board. Okay? Because I want to give back to back such one more example after this is done as in self-learning practice. Understood? That's why you need to understand the topic properly. 15 upon 4. Just 3 minutes left, dear student. Make it more faster. Understand? Then we will definitely solve it here on the board, so that you can understand it. Okay, and then one more such example for SLP for you, but first you need to do this. 15 upon 4, that is your target first. Just 1 minute now, dear student, to make the example representing this irrational, this rational number, which is improper fraction on the number line. Understood? Okay, can we solve it now? See, dear student, improper fraction टू बी कन्वर्टेड इनटू मिक्स्ड फ्रैक्शन. ओके डियर स्टूडेंट, जस्ट डू द डिवीजन. यू गॉट 3. सो नाउ यू नो इट इज कैन बी रिप्रेजेंटेड दिस वे इन मिक्स्ड फ्रैक्शन. व्हाट इज दैट? It was the number 15 upon 4 which is converted into mixed fraction as 3 integer 3 upon 4. So obviously the number lies between which two integer means rational number 3 and 4. Okay, let us draw the number line. Number line has been drawn. Rest of the number, if you want to show, dear student, you can. Okay, somewhat one I saw here. Okay, I just want the portion between these two, between the integer 3 and 4 to be extended. Okay, this portion only between 3 and 4 to be extended. And this portion 3 and 4 to be divided in how many parts? 4 parts. So for that, 3 markings are sufficient, which will comfort you to divide the portion between 3 and 4 into 4 parts. Okay, how to label the number here, dear student? This way, 3 integer 1 upon 4, 3 integer 2 upon 4, 3 integer 3 upon 4. And this is, dear student, the number you must have represented this way on the number line. Okay, many of you who must have paid attention and must be alert are able to represent this number quite clearly with comfort on the number line. Okay, is it clear in your mind? So my dear student, one such more example for just instantaneous SLP 39 upon 5. Please try this out in time interval of 4 to 5 minutes. Okay, the number given is 39 upon 5. Try this out. 39 upon 5. Okay, it is take time, but understand the concept and also understand that when you convert any such rational number which are improper fraction into mixed fraction, no mistake should occur. Concentrate on this and try this out for yourself. Understand? Make it little fast. But when you represent any rational number on number line, you have to be very conscious and draw the number line properly. Not only that, but also draw the number line neatly, and the interval which you are dividing into parts has to look equal. That you should take care about. Understood? First you look at this, try this out, and then we will solve it for you so that you can understand and revise it. Number is 39 upon 5 to be represented on the number line. So you need to be very conscious to convert it into mixed fraction and then represent on the number line. You need to decide the interval, okay, between which two rational number it lies. That also you first need to verify. 39 upon 5. First you tell you this. Just 1 minute now, dear student, left for you to complete the example, and then we will do it here on the board so that you can verify with your representation on the number line. You need to verify with it. Understand? 39 upon 5. We'll just solve in a short time, okay? 39 upon 5. Just you first have a look at this, okay? Then we'll solve it here. Okay, let us now solve. It is 39 upon 5. Let us convert it into mixed fraction. Understand, 5, 7, 35, 4 is the remainder. So in mixed fraction you can write 7 integer 4 upon 5, okay? So converted into mixed fraction, 7 integer 4 upon 5. Now you decide the interval of two rational number between which this number lies, 7 and next integer, obviously 8, okay? So it lies between 7 and 8, that is decided. Now, number line first. Okay, our target is 7 and 8. Rest at least the previous integers. You need to saw this way. You need to saw it, okay? Then, as you know, the portion between 7 to 8 is expanded. The portion between 7 to 8 is expanded because this number lies in the range of 7 to 8. The portion between 7 to 8 is to be divided into how many parts? 5 parts. See this. And for that, you need 4 markings. Okay? Let us write here. What you will write here, dear student? 7 integer 1 upon 5. 7 integer 2 upon 5. 7 integer 3 upon 5. 7 integer 4 upon 5. Rest you do not have to write. 7 integer 1 upon 5 upon 5 becomes 8 only. So this is the number you must have represented in this particular way on the number line. Just have a look at this. This is the way you have to represent the given number. And here also in previous example, as I mentioned, once you represent, you need to write, you can 39 upon 5, okay? First, just have a look at this, dear student, and look at the sum you verified. Understand? You have done. You just need to verify with the example already done by you, okay? Clear? Let us go for another example, number 10. Example number 10. Okay, representation of, no doubt, rational number on the number line. Topic remains same. Example number 10. Let me write the sum minus 26 upon 7. This is to be represented on number line. Though negative, but we know it is improper fraction because numerator is greater than denominator. Let us convert it into mixed fraction first, okay? In mixed fraction, 7, 7, 3 are 21, and 5 is the remainder. So, dear student, you understood this? 3 integer 5 upon 7, but as it is negative rational number, you have to write minus 3 integer 5 upon 7. Now, dear student, converted into mixed fraction, but it is negative. So, please concentrate, no mistake whatsoever should occur. It lies between, which is this integer, minus 3, the next one, minus 4, because in negative you have to move from right to left, minus 3 and minus 4. So, two rational numbers are decided. It lies between minus 3 and minus 4. Let us draw the number line, okay? First the number line, then dear student, you can start from here, 1, 0, okay, minus 1 I can mention, minus 2 I can mention, minus 3 and minus 4. To be extended to facilitate the representation of this number. It lies between minus 3 and minus 4. To be divided into how many part? 7 part, and for that 6 marking, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. 6 marking will divide the interval between minus 3 and minus 4 into 7 parts. Starting from here, dear student, minus 3, integer 1 upon 5, oh sorry, 1 upon 7, then minus 3 integer 2 upon 7, minus 3 integer 3 upon 7, minus 3 integer 4 upon 7, minus 3 integer 5 upon 7, minus 3 integer 6 upon 7. This is your number, okay? So this is the way you can represent improper fraction. Here I can also mention the original rational number, minus 26 upon 7, okay? Just look at the sum, dear student, and then I will give you one similar example, understand, for self-learning practice just now. In negative, you have to concentrate from right to left, okay? Right to left, you have to move. Okay, have you verified it properly? Let me give you one example number 11 as self-learning for you. Okay, it is like this: minus 7 upon, okay, minus 7 upon, let me give you 4 or 5. Try this out. Just in 2 minutes time. Okay, try this out. It is minus 7 upon 5, which you have to represent on number line, minus 7 upon 5. In short interval of time, you have to solve this, understand, and present it on the number line. We want in revision lecture the SLP on spot so that you can understand the example instantaneously by yourself. Just verify. Minus 7 upon 5. Okay, just tally the example given here. Just 1 minute more, dear student. Can we do it now? 7 upon 5 to be converted into mixed fraction. Okay, so it is one integer 2 upon 5, but because it is negative, you will write minus 1 integer 2 upon 5. Minus 1, obviously it lies between minus 1 and minus 2. So, dear student, you can write 1, 0, okay, minus 1, let us extend minus 2. It lies between minus 1 and minus 2. Portion between minus 1 and minus 2 to be divided in 5 parts. So, how many marking? 4 markings, okay? To comfort division in 5 parts, okay? Right? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Let us write from here, minus 1 integer 1 upon 5, minus 1 integer 2 upon 5, minus 1 integer 3 upon 5, minus 1 integer 4 upon 5, minus 1 integer, understood? 1 upon 5, 2 upon 5, 3 upon 5. Here they just have to represent minus 2, okay? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 parts already done. This is the number you are looking for. Minus 1 integer 2 upon 5, and you need to mention the original number you are presenting, minus 7 upon 5. Okay, please verify this and verify with the example you have done. Okay, just have a look at this. Is it clear in your mind? Okay, so my dear student, what we have done in today's lecture number 5, I have explained you in today's lecture representation of all improper fraction, either negative or positive, on the number line. And I expect that you must have caught the points which has been explained, because in exam or in test when you represent, it is you. Understand? This is yourself to decide whether it is proper, improper, positive, negative, in which interval it lies. That is what you have to decide it. Okay, dear student? So please practice at home, be alert, and whatever revision topic has been explained, please concentrate on all the topics. Understand? Thank you very much from Bharat sir.